By now, the coronavirus is more than just an epidemic. It has become a test of adequacy for the governments of as many as 47 countries. Its impact is worsening with each passing day. Global markets are crashing, major events are being cancelled, and several parts of the world are under lockdown. There is also growing mistrust mixed with misgovernance. Let me first start by telling you about the global death toll and the latest numbers. Starting from the epicenter, China, the country says the death toll has now risen to 2,788. Beyond China, 2 in Hong Kong, 13 in South Korea. Not far away, Japan has recorded 8 deaths, 1 each in Taiwan and in Philippines. Iran is the worst hit with 34 deaths and counting. Italy has confirmed 17 deaths. Speaking of infections now, there are now 83,000 global cases of the virus. 78,824 are in mainland China itself. There are infections in every continent on the planet except for Antarctica. South Korea has recorded the most cases outside China now. The figure has surpassed the 2,000 mark. More and more countries are confirming fresh cases every day. The virus has now also reached sub-Saharan Africa. Cases have been reported in Lagos and Nigeria. New Zealand has also confirmed its first case now. A traveller from Iran recently tested positive. From earlier refusing to label the outbreak as a global health scare to now calling for collective action, the World Health Organization has now emphasized on the urgency of dealing with the threat.
We're at a decisive point. For the past 2 days, the number of new cases reported in the rest of the world has exceeded the number of new cases reported from China. This is not a time for fear. This is a time for taking action now to prevent infections and save lives now.
The UN chief has also asked every single country in the world to be prepared. He says we must listen to the WHO. It would be stupid not to. Those are his words. Take a listen in.
All countries, and this is now a problem that is affecting many countries in the world, all countries must do everything to be prepared, and all countries must do everything, respecting naturally the principle of non-discrimination, without stigmatization, respecting human rights, but doing everything that they can to contain the disease. If there is something completely stupid to do in today's world, is not to fully fund WHO appeals. Because WHO appeals are vital to support member states to avoid this tragic disease to become a global nightmare.
Back in China, the authorities are cracking down on wildlife trade. Licenses are being revoked from organizations that are breeding protected animals for consumption. Wildlife trade in markets has been banned. Heavy fines of up to 20,000 yuan, that is close to $3,000, now being levied in order to clamp down on the sale of protected animal meat.
We have made a clear requirement of isolation of breeding grounds for wildlife across the nation, stop all trade of wildlife in markets and transportation, and strictly fight against illegal hunt and trade of wildlife.
And the crisis continues to get bizarre as well. In Hong Kong, the pet dog of a coronavirus patient has now been quarantined. The health authorities have found traits of the virus in the dog's medical samples. Since the WHO has ruled out any evidence of pets catching the infection, it remains to be seen how relevant the symptoms really are.
So AFCD colleagues have taken some samples for testing of this pets, and then found out that one of the dog has been tested weakly positive. So it is not sure whether the dog is really suffering from the infection or is because of environmental contamination of the dog's mouth and nose. So further tests will be conducted for the dog to check, and until the test result is negative, the dog will not be returned to the owner.
On to Iran now. We just told you the death toll there has risen to 34, the highest number of fatalities outside China. As per estimates, 388 people have been infected. For our viewers in Iran, the vast majority of infections are in three provinces, 128 in Tehran, 88 in the Qom province, and 65 in the province of Gilan. By all indications, this figure may increase by the time I conclude this report. Today, the Islamic Republic cancelled Friday prayers in the capitals of 23 of its 31 provinces. There are some big political names as well who have been infected. As many as six government officials. It has caused the death of a cleric diplomat, Hadi Khosrowshahi. Some prominent leaders infected by the virus include the Vice President for Women and Family Affairs, Masume Eftekar, the Deputy Health Minister, Iraj Harishi, her head of the Parliament's National Security Affairs Committee, Mojtaba Zonor, Mahmoud Sadeghi, a member of Parliament from Tehran, the Mayor of District 13 in Tehran, Morteza Ramzadeh, Mohammad Reza Gadir, the head of the Coronavirus Management Committee in Qom. Just next door in Pakistan, there is panic over the news of two confirmed cases now. Schools have been shut in the province of Sindh and down south in the country's Karachi as well. The western province of Balochistan has sealed its borders with Iran. Close to 8,000 pilgrims who recently returned from Iran are being monitored very closely. On to India, the country may have defeated the virus, but yesterday we told you how the Indian economy has been bearing the brunt. Today the situation is no better. The coronavirus has gripped the markets. Reports say Indian investors have lost close to 10 lakh crores in six sessions amid fears of a global recession. Today the Indian benchmark indices again surrender to the global free fall. The coronavirus threat has swept across nearly 4 lakh crore rupees within minutes of the Indian market's opening. Both the Nifty and the Sensex opened in red and saw deep cuts in early trade. Sensex suffered sharp losses of over 1,500 points, while the Nifty sank below 11,200 points. India is taking a cue from the global markets that also remain spooked. There are significant declines on the Wall Street. And world over, the markets are sinking deeper into the red zone. This is the coronavirus story for now.